In this video, I'll take you through the design and setup process for implementing a total of 37 IP CCTV cameras that are to be installed in a two-story facility, with the layout for each floor as captured on your screen, indicating the number of cameras to be installed on each floor of the building. All the cameras are to be monitored at a central location in the building, and so we'll be using a 48 channel NVR for this project. We'll not use a single PoE switch at a central location to link up the cameras, since some of the cameras are located more than 100 meters from the central location, but we'll rather place a PoE switch at each floor of the building in order to prevent laying cables that are too long, whereby resulting in the loss of power, which may also result in the inability of the cameras to be properly powered up. So at the first floor, which has 8 cameras, we'll place an 8-port megabit PoE switch, and then we'll connect all the 8 cameras on that floor to the PoE switch. On the second floor, we'll use a 16-port PoE switch. This is a megabit switch anyway, to which we'll connect the 14 cameras on that floor. And then the last floor too, we'll use a 16-port PoE switch and connect all the cameras on that floor also into the switch on that floor as well. We'll then get, in this time round, an 8-port gigabit switch placed at the central location where all the cameras are to be received. The gigabit switch is essential here because it offers an increased bandwidth and speed to be able to accommodate the traffic that will be coming from all the cameras from all the 3 floors. So that is why we'll have to use a gigabit switch at this point. So with that said, we'll pick the uplink port of the switch at the first floor, and then we can take it to the gigabit switch. We will do the same for the second floor and then the third floor as well. So what it means is that we now have a link, or we are now connecting a cable from each of the switches at each floor, and we are bringing them into the gigabit switch at the central location. We can then connect the NVR also to the gigabit switch, so that the NVR will be able to assess all the cameras that are coming from all the floors through the various network switches. Of course, we'll establish a connection from the NVR to the monitoring screen, which would display the NVR's interface showing the cameras on the network switches. We can introduce an internet router if we wish to view the cameras remotely. The router can also be plugged into the gigabit switch, and from there, internet will be served to all the devices connected to this gigabit switch, which means the cameras will have internet and the NVR as well. In case we wish to view all these cameras on a computer in addition to the monitoring screen, we can either connect the computer directly to the router, or we can connect it to the gigabit switch, of which any of those ways works perfectly. One way to view the cameras on a computer is to have a VMS installed on the computer, through which we can access all these cameras on this network with the use of the computer. And in some other instances, for some IP camera brands, you can directly type the IP address of each camera in a web browser in order to view the individual cameras on your computer. Or you can sometimes type the IP address of the NVR on which the cameras are connected, and you'll be able to view the cameras on your computer, that is using a web browser. With the computer view, you can access your cameras on as many computers as you wish. All you need is the connection of the computer or the computers to the network to which the cameras are connected, in a similar way as I have demonstrated on this illustration, and everything will function perfectly. Please feel free to drop your comments and questions in the comment section of this video, and I'll take time to respond to all of them appropriately. But if you find value in this video, please ensure you give it a thumbs up. It gives us lots of encouragement to do more of these videos. Thank you so much for watching this video. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.